changing that atmosphere, bringing hope back at the pan-European level, is going to be the prerequisite for us to have the discussion of democratizing Europe, of creating a democratic constitution by which to replace the treaties, and moving ahead, if we so choose, in the context of citizens' assemblies, where from the grassroots up we discuss what kind of future governance we want for Europe, we can create the circumstances for the democratization process. Now, some skeptics from the left say, ah, that will never work. You will run in the May elections. You know, even if you do well, the European Parliament cannot enact everything, anything of what you're saying. You have to take over the governments in order to do that. By that time, there will be a coup d'etat like there was in Greece against you in July 2015. It's not going to work. It's going to fail. Well, maybe. But think about it. Who is going to pick up the pieces if this Europe collapses? Who is going to do it? The nationalists of the right or of the left? Or those of us who struggled to save Europe from itself? Or those of us who try to bring everybody together on the basis of something like the European Spring Program? We are the ones that will pick up the pieces if Europe collapses. And to be together across Europe, from Portugal all the way to Ireland, from France all the way to Greece, the Baltics and so on. We need a pan-European transnational list with one program that binds us together, which shows us what is possible within the existing rules, paves the ground for us to change the rules. And that very movement will also be the only movement that is capable of preserving civilization in Europe if the whole thing collapses because of the fascists, the nationalists, and the European bureaucracy.